Yesterday, we have understood like the sixth problem, like to move the up above the inclined plane and to move the down. Okay, that is sixth. And seventh question, continuation only. How much force to be applied? We have understood to move up and to move the down. And if the force is applied horizontally and not parallel to the inclined plane, then how much force to be applied? They are asking the question. Okay. So yesterday we understood, I think, free body diagram we have understood, and we started yesterday. So this is what inclined plane. Free body diagram. Mg component, mg cos theta, mg sin theta. Since we have to move upwards, the frictional force will act downwards. Mu into normal, so I have shown here downwards. And F is also acting horizontally at an angle 30 degree. So F should also be resolved into two components. F cos theta, F sin theta. So along the incline, F cos theta, and another component downwards, F sin theta. Okay. So here, very, very important. F is also resolved into components, weight is also resolved into components, and normal force changes. So normal force, there is no vertical motion of the body, so normal force should be not only mg or not mg cos theta, it should be mg cos theta plus f sin theta. That is very, very important. So if you know this, all the forces which are acting, okay, then it's done. Your answer is done. Okay. So these are the forces. So net force equation, vertical to the incline. So normal force will be not only mg cos theta, it will be mg cos theta plus f sin theta. This is very, very important. Okay. Then afterwards, along the incline plane, if you write the net force equation, so f cos theta upwards, and remaining all forces downwards. So net force will be net force F cos theta is equal to mu into normal force plus mg sin theta. So normal force value mg cos theta plus F sin theta you have to substitute. And from there you have to substitute mg theta value, mu value, then you will get the force to be applied. Answer you should get it as around 17.5 or 17.7. Okay. Next problem. This child is playing in a park. The angle of inclination is 45 degree. Okay. So in a children park, an inclined plane is constructed with an angle of incline 45 degree in the middle part. Okay. Find the acceleration of the boy sliding on it if the friction coefficient between the cloth of the boy and the incline is 0.6 and g is 10 meter per second square. So we have already learned the basics. So you just use the acceleration formula, g sin theta minus mu g cos theta. Theta is 45, mu is 0.6, g is 10. Just to simplify this, you will get the answer, acceleration. Answer you should get it as 2 root 2. Next question, a body starts slipping down an incline and moves half meter in half second. How long will it take to move the next half meter? Next half meter. Okay. So they have given for first half meter, they have given some data. V is equal 0, S is equal 0.5. First half meter means S is equal 0.5 and time is 0.5. From here you find out acceleration, and for second half meter time is 0.5 only, and velocity after 0.5 seconds you have to find out the velocity, and that becomes a u, final velocity actually, and after 0.5 seconds it becomes u, and next to half meter, so s is equal 0.5 meter acceleration you got from the previous, so we have to find out the time. Okay, so first find out the acceleration with the given data. U is 0, S is 0.5, T is 0.5, A you find out. Acceleration is 4, yes, correct. 4 meter per second square. With that data, you find out velocity after 0.5 seconds using first equation of motion. Yeah, velocity 2 meter per second is very good. Now velocity is there, acceleration is there, displacement is also, S is equal 0.5 meter they have given, next to half meter. So time is what? Use the same equation again, S is equal ut plus half a square. And find out time where.
Sir, 0.21 seconds, sir.
Oh, this much fast you found, huh? 0.21 seconds. Okay. To move next to half meter, you will get around 0.21 seconds. Okay. The next. The angle between the resultant contact force and the normal force exerted by a body on the other is called the angle of friction. Okay. Show that if lambda be the angle of friction and mu is the coefficient of static friction, lambda is less than or equal to tan inverse mu. Okay, so let us see. First, to try to understand the diagram, this is the diagram. Normal force upwards, let us say applied force is rightwards, frictional force will be leftwards. And the resultant of frictional force and normal force is contact force, FC. I have indicated with FC. F is capital F is applied force, capital N is normal force, small f frictional force, and FC contact force. And the angle between them, FC and normal force, is lambda, which is called as angle of friction. Okay. So we have to show lambda is, we have to show lambda is less than or equal to tan inverse mu. So simply just form a right angle triangle like this. Leftwards frictional force, upwards normal force, and FC is the resultant force. You apply tan lambda, tan theta, then it becomes F by lambda. F by normal force, opposite by adjacent, and tan lambda is equal to mu. So this is tan lambda is equal to mu. then lambda is equal to tan inverse mu. We have substituted F is equal to mu normal force, then lambda is tan inverse mu. If F is less than mu into normal force, then lambda is less than tan inverse mu. Okay. If F is less than mu into normal force, lambda is tan less than tan inverse mu. If F is mu into n, then lambda is tan inverse mu. So if you, we have already learned, like static frictional force sometimes less than the limit, like most of the times it is less than the limiting force. Like mu into n means it is limiting force, and it is not always mu into n only. So sometimes frictional force will be less than mu into n also when you apply less amount of force. So finally we can tell that lambda is less than or equal to tan inverse mu. Okay, we have proved it. You note it. I will share this document in the group. The next 11th one. Consider the situation. See, 1 kg is kept on the surface, and 0.5 kg through the pulley it was hanging. Okay. You have to find out the acceleration. You have to find out the tension for 1 kg block, tension for 0.5 kg block. So this can be solved by drawing the free body diagram for each block. For 1 kg block, another 1 kg block, and 0.5 kg block. Three free body diagrams, three equations, three variables, acceleration and T1, T2. You can find out. So first you try to draw free body diagram. You can cross check your answers. First 1 kg block, tension 1, rightwards. Since one body is hanged, net force will also act rightwards. Net force rightwards, 1A is rightwards, MA. T1, tension 1 rightwards. And leftwards, frictional force will be there. Why? Because net force is rightwards. Okay. And if you do that, net force equation, if you write, M1A is equal to T1 minus mu into M1G. This is one equation. The next, for second block, left side T1, right side T2. And net force is rightwards, so frictional force will be leftwards. So net force equation along the surface, if you write, M2A is equal to T2 minus T1 minus mu M2G. Okay. Then again, for third body, 0.5 kg block, T2 upwards, weight downwards, net force downwards. So M3A is equal to 0.5G minus T2. So three equations are there. So three variables. I'll just give 2-3 minutes. Try to find out. Next, in the same way, if the tension in the string is 16 Newton and the acceleration is given 0.5 meter per second square, find the friction coefficients at the two contacts. So you have to find out for the 2 kg block, mu1 frictional coefficient is there, na? That mu1 is also to be found, and for 4 kg, mu2 you have to find. Okay, so same thing, the two free body diagrams you draw, two equations you will get, and two variables, mu1 and mu2. So, but you have to be very careful while drawing the free body diagram. Okay, so this is what. So for the 2 kg block, 16 newton tension is given rightwards, and leftwards frictional force. Net force is rightwards. So from there, M1A is equal to 16 minus mu 1 M1G. And for inclined surface, free body diagram. M2G sin theta downwards. And M2A is downwards. Tension is upwards, 16 newton. And frictional force is upwards since net force is downwards. So mu 2 m 2 g cos theta downward upwards frictional force. So again one more equation. M 2 a is equal to m 2 g sin theta is also working downwards only. So m 2 g sin theta minus upward forces 16 plus mu 2 m 2 g cos theta. Just substitute. M1, M2, theta, acceleration, all you substitute in first and second equation, and you will try to get the answer. So if you solve it, mu1 is 0.75, you will get mu2 0.06, you will get. The next question. The friction coefficient between the table and the block is shown as shown in the figure is 0.2. Find the tension in the two strings. Same thing. Again, you have to draw free body diagrams. For 15 kg, 5 kg which is kept on the surface, 5 kg which is hanging. So for the hanged masses, there is no frictional force beta in the equations. You please take care. For the 5 kg mass which is kept on the surface, there will be frictional force. Okay. So, if you. So, please first you try. So, for the first block, tension upwards, weight downwards, net force downwards. Why? Because 15 kg is more than the 5 kg which is hanged rightwards. So, if you draw free. If you write free net force equation, 15A is equal to 15G minus T1, first equation. And for second body, tension 1 leftwards, tension 2 rightwards, and frictional force will be rightwards. Why? Because net force is leftwards. So, if you write the free net force equation, 5A is equal to T1 minus T2 minus F. F is nothing but mu mg. That is second equation. Then for third body, T2 upwards, weight downwards, net force upwards, third equation. Okay. So solve these three equations, you will get tension 1 and tension 2. You will get acceleration also. A, T1, T2, all you will get if you solve three equations.